Chris's brother Andrew Havis hits the hill next. Now Andrew's a formula racer and he's putting his road skills to work on the paved sections. On these lower sections, you can see that there's just as much danger as up high. You've got rocks, trees, everything right next to the road, and no guardrails. Over 100 corners, and this guy seems to know them all. Now, Andrew was the record setter last year. He had a 729.67. He'll be looking to better that this year in today's near-perfect conditions. Through the Craigway, you can see he's a little bit slower on the dirt, but he again makes up for it as soon as he hits those paved sections. At the finish here, 713.72, a new record for Class 3.
It was a pretty fun ride. Last year I had done a 729, and this year I broke that by 13 seconds and went 16 seconds and went a 713 on a first run. I'm pretty happy about that.
You think there's any chance to do better for the second run, conditions being the way they are?
Yeah, having a little trouble finally getting the carburetors dialed in because all during practice the weather changed and the humidity has an effect on the jetting that you run. So we're going to richen it up for the second run and hopefully get a little bit more power on the top end. And I'm going to see if I can bust into the tens.
Class 3, Andrew Havis, looking to break the record. This car is built for the hill climb. He knows the road. A little bit of drift here in the dirt, but he makes up for it once he gets onto the pavement. You can see the left foot braking he uses all the way up the hill to control the car. Coming into the finish now, 707.33, that's the record and the class win.
I made a couple of mistakes. I should have been faster, but I'm really pleased to go 707. That's faster than I ever thought I would be able to do, and I'm just really pleased. Finally, the car is mechanically pretty much all there.